1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 W's, bro. And we only lost one game. Y'all better stop sleeping on my boys, bro. Like, we really out here, bro. Like, they think we playing. Like, they think we not really for real. Like, we really out here, man. We really in that field. My Dallas Cowboys played the Cleveland Browns yesterday afternoon, man. And we straight, I mean, from start to finish, we was just on these dudes from start to finish, man. And most people gonna say, well, it's the Browns, and they was 0-8. You supposed to, bro, listen, man. That's not necessarily the case. And the main reason is because that's what you call a trap game. You're looking at the schedule and you're seeing how bad a team's record is, and then you naturally go into this mode where we're just gonna come out, we're going through the motions, and basically not showing up ready to play. And that's how you get your butt beat by a team that's 0-8. And you go home with an L, giving them their first win of the season. Bro, this the NFL, people. I don't care what your record is. You can lose any given night, all right? The Browns 0-8. Like, they could have won some of them games, but they lost. But coming into the game, bro, I expected so much out of Zeke. I'm like, bro, this is Zeke homecoming. This the Browns. They got, like, the worst run defense in the league. Boy, if my boy don't get, like, 130, 150, I'm going to be disappointed. And I was, bro, but it's all good, man. My man's had 2 touchdowns. Dak had 3 touchdowns. Dak didn't turn the ball over. Zeke fumbled it, but he didn't turn the ball over. So we was good, man. You know, I was scared what our defense might look like. I don't care what game it is, bro. I'm always on edge about our defense because we lost Morris Claiborne now. But, man, what? Wait a minute. Rolando McClain, was he suspended? He suspended 10 games, right? That boy need to hurry up and come back because we need some help on the defensive side, bro. But I was worried, man, but we held our own, man, so it's all good. Well, I ain't gonna lie, though. They were going against a rookie quarterback, so, you know, Cody Kessler, you know, I don't really know what he can do, so I wasn't too much worried, you know. But, I don't know, I guess it's natural for me to just have some kind of anxiety when it comes to the Cowboys defense. But you know, once the game started and I realized, you know, we are playing a rookie quarterback, I was able to settle in and relax. But Dez, bro, come on, man. If I'm not mistaken, this dude, after yesterday's game, he only got 16 catches all year. Now, I understand you've been hurt, but you wasn't hurt yesterday, bro. You wasn't hurt yesterday. I mean, drop passes, crying for calls. Dropping passes is cool. When you dropping touchdown passes, bro, first down passes, that makes a difference. Hey, it is what it is, man. As long as we got the W, the Cowboys did, I don't know if y'all seen it, but the Cowboys did that mannequin challenge. I thought that was cool. I don't know about anybody else, but when I was watching the mannequin challenge video, I was looking at the video, looking for Dez. Like, is he gonna be a team guy? Is he somewhere involved in this? Is he being a team guy right now? So I was happy to see Dez in the video participating. Yo, Zeke was in there. I didn't see Dak. Maybe I did. I can't remember seeing Dak. Maybe he was in it, but I don't remember. But like I said, I was expecting Zeke to have like 150, 250 yards. Man, I'm telling you, I had like some real unrealistic expectations. Well, that ain't really unrealistic, bro, because it's the Browns and it's the worst defense against the running back with the most yards. That ain't really unrealistic to expect 200 yards, is it? Like, I really wanted him to have a big game. It was his homecoming. He was back in Ohio. Like, I wanted the dude to just dominate. But, of course, he couldn't, man. We was beating him so bad. They had Zeke out the game with like 8 minutes left in the fourth quarter, so they just left him at 92. I was like, man, bro, y'all can't let him get in the game and get 8 more yards, man. I just wanted to get 100 yards. He only had 98 last week. I was upset about that. Now you finish this week with 92. Like, let my mans get to the 100s and then come out the game. I'm saying that now. He go in there and get the carry, get hurt. I'm going to be crying like a mug. But scratch that off the schedule. On to the next one, man. Got Pittsburgh next week. Bro, I can't believe Big Ben came back that fast, bro. I thought when he had that surgery, he was supposed to be gone for like a month. This dude missed one game, dog. And I feel like he came back too soon because Pittsburgh was terrible last night, bro. But it's all good, man. Everybody said we're supposed to be scared of Pittsburgh. Man, we ain't worried about nothing. You know, we're going to go into the steel tower. We're going to go to the steel curtain, man. We're going to bring that in up. You hear me? We got Zeke. And we got this offensive line, and we got a young rookie quarterback, and we got Dez. Even though Dez was a no-show yesterday, we still got Dez. Don't sleep on my mans. You know what he can do. If you sleeping on Dez, you are so disrespectful. Don't be disrespectful. Always respect everybody, y'all. It's B. Collins. My guys, kings, and queens, remember to love somebody and hug somebody.
You hear that?
And you gone today.
I'm out.